Member for Esquimalt Royal Roads.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. So, Honourable Speaker, let's remember that this whole triple delete scandal was exposed because we in the opposition asked for records on the Highway of Tears. And then, of course, Tim Duncan blew the whistle on this government for breaking the law and forcing him to destroy some of those very records. When we asked this government why they were refusing to act on the urgent recommendations from the OPAL report, the minister told us that people in the Northwest said it was the wrong approach and they didn't want a bus. Of course, we knew this couldn't be true, Honourable Speaker, because my colleagues and I drove that highway, met with community members along that highway, and were told firsthand the very opposite of what the minister has said. Now, after an FOI fight that has taken a year, guess what? We were correct. The FOI shows that the people in the Northwest actually did tell this government that they wanted public transportation. So my question is to the Minister of Transportation, why is this government continuing to suppress the voices of the murdered and missing women and their families along this highway by refusing to take action on public transportation?
Here, here.
Minister for Transportation and Infrastructure.
Well, thank you very much, Honourable Speaker. First off, I will say this. The Commissioner in her report indicated that the original request, the 36 pages that were requested of the Ministry of Transportation, the scope that was applied to that request was too narrow. We agree with that, with her finding, and as a result, we said immediately upon receipt of her report that we would endeavour as quickly as possible to release those records. Those records were released to the opposition last Friday. Honourable Speaker, they were loaded onto OpenGov yesterday. In addition to that, we also released almost 600 additional pages of information, records, pertaining to Highway 16 that represented the culmination of records requests dating back to 2012 on Highway 16. Those records were also provided to the opposition as a courtesy on Friday. They have all been uploaded to OpenGov as well. Honourable Speaker, I will also say this. The member will see through those records. As I have stated in this House and outside this House, that this government has been working very, very hard with communities along Highway 16 and First Nations in particular to identify strategies to make the corridor safer. We will continue with that work because at the end of the day, we all want to ensure that folks who live along Highway 16 can do so knowing that that corridor is as safe as it possibly can be.
Esquimalt Royal Roads on a supplemental.
Thank you very much, Honourable Speaker. For a year, we have fought in this House with this minister who has intentionally hidden the records until 24 hours ago when it was made public. And in fact, those records say the complete opposite of what we have been hearing from this minister and this government time and time again. Let me quote from this bunch of Freedom of Information that was dumped into the public domain yesterday. It directly contradicts the minister's spin lines. Here is what the notes said from these meetings, what the stakeholders actually said when they were consulted. Here's a quote. There might be opportunities to create an interconnected network through which passengers might travel from Prince Rupert to Smithers, for example, and then connect to another bus. Another quote. A need to develop BC Transit in smaller communities. Honourable Speaker, people on this corridor have been asking for exactly what the Missing and Murdered Women's Commission recommended, an enhanced public transportation system along Highway 16 that this government has denied time and time and time again. So I'd like to know why the minister misrepresented what those community leaders had told him and in fact has dishonoured the victims, their families, and has continued to deceive the public.
Minister for Transportation and Infrastructure.
Thank you very much, Honourable Speaker. It continues to disappoint many that the member opposite and her colleagues continue to opt for politics over policy with respect to Highway 16. Our government has been working extremely hard with communities and First Nations to identify practical...
Members. Members.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. We are continuing to work very hard with communities, First Nations, local government leaders and others up and down Highway 16 to identify practical options that will improve safety along that corridor, Honourable Speaker. But as I've also mentioned, the highway is safer today than it was 5 years ago, 10 years ago, 15 years ago, because of investments that this government has made in transit, connecting communities, in a northern health bus, in expanding cellular coverage across the region. We've also provided dollars to the Carrier Sicani for driver education and training. We've set up a web portal to connect better connect all of the resources that are available. And we're going to continue to do the work. There is a symposium that we are co-sponsoring with the First Nations Health Authority that will be held in Smithers in only a matter of weeks, where local government leaders, First Nations, will be coming together with the Ministry and with the First Nations Health Authority to continue the discussion to identify further strategies to make this corridor even safer.
Thank you, sir.